extra time to kind of tip their toe in the water. It's we try to make it reasonable. It's not full fees and they're not fully vested. And obviously there's the full membership for that person who maybe has just retired or just wants more out of the club, and the club becomes an extension of their lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
The summer membership that you were talking to,
yep,
I see them in most clubs in South Florida. Fort Lauderdale does have one as well. In its original form, it was an opportunity for one of our members to reach out to their friends and business associates, bring them to the club for a six-month period of time. There's plenty of vacancies in the summer on all golf courses in South Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the original concept. It did morph into an opportunity to make some money.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we probably, when we originally drafted it, we're looking to just bring 50 friends and business associates. I've seen it swell to as many as 165. I will tell you, at least at Fort Lauderdale Country Club, that pendulum is now going the other way. We will begin to look at using it in its intent, which is bring somebody to the club, give them an opportunity to use it a summer or two, no more than two, and if they like it, then make some decisions on one of the longer-term memberships that we have. And that works all the time throughout the life of the club, probably.
Okay, now we're just about out of time, I think. Now that we've kind of whet everybody's appetite, because who wouldn't want to be a member of the Fort Lauderdale Country Club? I assume the best way to get more information would be go to your website?
You can go to our website. It's quite simple, www.fortlauderdalecc.com.
Mm-hmm.
And it's that website that we have is very interactive. You can see all aspects of the club. And probably get a lot of the answers that you may have if you're thinking about what it is about Fort Lauderdale Country Club that you might want to know. And then certainly you can always call myself or Valerie Roken, who's our membership director, at the club's number, which is 954-587-4700. And either of the two of us would be more than happy to speak to you, any of your listening audience, and answer all the questions.
Well, I certainly had a wonderful time there on Wednesday. Thank you for the hospitality. And if anybody is listening, I certainly could recommend it. So go check it out, and hopefully we'll send some new members your way.
Thanks for giving me a shout and having this opportunity.
Hey, it's my pleasure, Michael. Hopefully I'll see you again soon.
Okay.
All righty. What we're going to do is take another quick break, and then we're going to be back with friend of the show, friend of mine, the table tennis ambassador to the world, often known as the Harlem Globetrotter of table tennis, none other than Scott Price. He's going to be talking about his recent trip to China. You're not going to want to miss it, so stay tuned, and we'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
Cinderella story, out of nowhere, a former greenskeeper now about to become the Masters champion.
It looks like I'm a wreck. It's in the hole!
I rap live, call me Chocolate Thunder, and I got good two going four strokes under. Get out the way if you want to go play, because I give it my all every single day. Have a lot of cash.
And we're back, and if your business needs industrial workers, or if you're looking for work, you got to call Labor Finders. Labor Finders places for temporary or temporary to hire opportunities for skilled, semi-skilled, or general labor positions such as plumbers, electricians, concrete workers, forklift operators, hospitality, office clerical, landscaping, and much, much more. Labor Finders has almost 200 offices nationwide. Near here in Boca Raton, they have offices in Homestead, Miami, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, Jupiter, and even in Colorado Springs. So if you need legal, insured workers, or if you're looking for work, call Labor Finders. Toll free at 800-864-7749. That's 800-864-7749, or visit laborfinders.com.
You on a slow boat to China, all to my
get you and keep you in my arms.
And we are back. And yeah, he's the guy who learned to play table tennis better in China, goes back every once in a while, visits some friends and relatives over there. It's a big country, though, so I guess it takes a while to see all of it. But for a glimpse of the part that he got to see, the crown prince of table tennis, the guy that puts on the best show in the game, none other than Hall of Famer Scott Price. Scott, how you doing?
Hey, Dan, how are you?
I am great. How are you?
I'm doing good. Sleep is starting to get in a normal pattern now. I've only been home about 72 hours.
It's so not easy coming from the other side of the world, huh?
16 hours ahead right now, so I think it's 8 o'clock at night on April 14th. I'm really not keeping that close to track, but I did want to tell you that I didn't have any slow boats to China, but a bullet train at 190 miles an hour.
Oof. And it probably stays on the tracks, unlike the ones in this country, huh?
It's incredible. It really is. The technology and the advancements in the 33 years that I'm going is really mind-boggling.
Now, you've obviously seen a lot of the country, but the country is huge. So where did you focus on this trip?
This particular trip was in South China in a very famous but remote city called Guilin, G-U-I-L-I-N. And this is only a few hours from the Vietnamese border and down in towards Macau in that area. And it was absolutely beautiful. A little primitive in areas, but really beautiful, beautiful scenery.
Now, did you see a lot of other tourists or American tourists, or pretty much it was just you?
Well, to be quite honest, in the first 7 days, I did not see one foreigner. No kidding.
Mm-hmm.
I was in as you know, my wife is from Shanghai. I agreed to go on a tour that was done all in Chinese.
So and how'd that work for you?
Well, the food was a little iffy, but the camaraderie was good. But my 200 to 300 words that I know in Chinese went a long way.
Uh-huh.
That's all I could say. But it's really fascinating to see a country that is just now building roads so that you can see the country. Many of the areas were unreachable. But this is the famous area where you probably have seen the Misty Mountains and the river.
Mm-hmm. And it sounds like a Led Zeppelin song.
Yeah, this is that part of the country called Guilin. I also went to Shanghai and another remote city called Jiangzhou, and that's where they have the famous rice fields. So being that my wife is an interpreter by trade, it's quite a lot easier for a Long Islander to trek around China with an interpreter, that's for sure.
I bet. So now how many days were you there for?
15.
Okay.
Yeah, I was 6 days in Shanghai and about 9 days outside of Shanghai. So, and Shanghai, of course, is a fascinating city. But for those that want to visit South China and this famous city, there are many flights from Shanghai to Guilin. It's about 2.5 hours. And again, pretty easy to get to, and I do recommend a tour so that you don't have to do anything. Just have them take you everywhere.
Well, especially if your wife isn't a translator, right?
Yeah, especially if you're not with a translator. But this particular one was done in Chinese, but there are tours in English, and it would be quite fascinating. I highly recommend it for the experience.
Okay, just because you just mentioned that, usually I save my deals for later in the show, but there's a website that I'm sure you're aware of, no relation to you. It's called Scott's Cheap Flights, and just today I saw airfares to Beijing. Okay, it's from LAX, I believe. Well, mostly LAX, but you could fly to Beijing, let's see, as little as $400 and some odd. That's how inexpensive it is now to fly to Beijing.
That's round trip, right?
Yes, round trip.
Round trip to LA, yeah. You know, just to let you know.
See, San Diego, 431.
Wow.
San Jose, 415.
We paid $500 on United on this one, just to let you know, which was very odd, right here from Colorado Springs.
Well, Orlando, $434. And this is not on a discount carry. This is American, Air Canada, Delta, Hainan, Hong Kong Airlines, or United. So in almost every city across the country right now, somewhere between $400 and maybe $650. crazy, right? I mean, what did you pay a couple of years ago to fly to China?
$1,200 is the usual round trip.
Crazy, so, right?
Yeah, well, you know, I just have to mention, as a seasoned traveler, you really want to avoid the warmer months. I highly recommend November and December, mm-hmm. even though it may be chilly, and March and April, because you'll miss the humidity and you'll miss, instead of having 1.4 billion, you'll have a half a billion people to deal with. So it's a little easier.
I'm sure it is. Now, have you had a chance to ever play any golf over in China?
You know, I have. I've played at a few places. One of them is owned by the Crown Plaza, and that is just west of the city of Shanghai.
Mm-hmm.
The other, there's three really beautiful plush clubs over there. One of them is called the Thompson Golf Club, and that's in Pudong, which is the financial capital of the world right now. That's the city that sits right next to Shanghai. And Thompson is T-O-M-S-O-N.
Mm-hmm.
It's a stunning golf course. They've played the PGA Tour there. And also the Shenzhen Golf Course, which I believe has five or six golf courses attached to them.
Neat.
And both of them are very high rated. That's S-H-E-S-H-A-N. But, Dan, I think that's what we have to do next. We need to go to China and play golf. We need to tell our wives this is very important.
Of course it is. And what does Las Vegas have the odds on that at right now?
Well, I'll be there in a few weeks. I'll let you know.
I know. Well, of course I will too, but not at the same time as you, which is most typical. Every once in a while we get lucky and we end up in the same city at the same time. Usually we're about 2-3 weeks apart from each other, which I think is going to happen.
No, I don't know how that happens.
I don't know. So listen, I have a question for you. What is the most unusual food that you ate in China, and did you like it or not?
Well, this trip, actually, I was exposed to a lot, but I'm actually very careful. There was eel, and there was chicken feet and frog's legs on this trip, but I passed on those. But when my wife's dad was alive before he passed away many years ago, I agreed to take him to his favorite restaurant in their neighborhood. And I agreed to eat his favorite food. They didn't want to tell me what it was.
Uh-oh.
Coming to my strangest food. So I sit down at a table of four with her dad across from me. And he was very ill, but he was psyched to have his meal. And then a black dish, it was a fish in a black dish, and it ended up that they were jumping out of the dish. They were shrimp, live shrimp soaked in vinegar and soy sauce to make them slow and drunk. And then you grab them and you eat them live.
That sounds cannibalistic to me.
And you spit out the head. So I took my chopsticks, I grabbed one in midair, I chewed off its head, spit it out, and it was a straight shot to the stomach. It didn't pass anything, did not pass go. So it was pretty painless, but I did it only once.
And you'll live to tell the tale.
Is the live shrimp without the head and tail, yeah.
It's funny because one of my strangest Asian experiences was in Flushing Meadows at the Lobster House, Chinese Lobster House, and the table next to me was served live lobsters to eat, and I thought that was a little unusual as well. They were all moving around, and I called the waitress over, and I said to her, excuse me, but those lobsters, it looks like they're still alive. They haven't been cooked. And she says, oh, yes, very fresh. It's like, well, that's the truth.
My goodness. Yeah, no. Luckily, my wife and I are on the same page. We eat vegetables most of the time and stay away from danger because you don't really want to be ill. In general, China has changed quite a bit in these years. It's very, very progressive. The way that they built the infrastructure and the trains and the subways, it's really fascinating. I do recommend going and taking a look and experiencing.
We know that it's cheap to fly there. Is it still inexpensive to be over there once you're living for hotels and food and drink and all that stuff? Or as they get more modernized, are the prices going up?
Quite honest, the popular hotels like the Marriotts and the Hiltons and these type of the Westins, very expensive. But if anybody was to type in the Trivago or Agoda or Kayak, you'll be a little bit shocked that for $50 to $75, you can still get a 4-star hotel in most places in China.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that they're government regulated hotels. Breakfast is always generally included.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that, for one, you won't be able to be on Facebook or your social media because they block those.
Mm-hmm.
And then the other things, you may find subpar conditions once in a while.
Mm-hmm.
But in general, yes, it's very reasonable, other than the high-level hotels, to stay in China.
Fair enough. Well, if anybody wants to get more information or more tips, they can always go to my Facebook page, and I can always ask you. So that's facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow. But, of course, when you're not busy vacationing and traveling throughout China, you're busy performing as a Hall of Famer, table tennis performer, putting on shows for corporations, for bar mitzvahs and weddings, for other kind of events, charity events, golf tournaments, you name it. So if people would like to book you or find out more information about your world of table tennis, which is a little bit of a different brand than some people may know about, what's the best way to find out more about what you're up to and how they could connect with you?
Well, I think the easiest way, Dan, is just pingpongman.com. Somebody has to do it, and that's me. My next show, by the way, you're invited, Dan, is over at the Olympic Committee in a few weeks.
Nice.
Maybe I can coerce you into coming out, playing a round of golf, challenging me there at the Olympic Center. What about it?
Well, we know how that always turns out when I challenge you. It's always ugly for me, at least. But having fun with you, no matter what, wherever we are, that's always the case. And anytime I could sneak away and meet you anywhere, you know I'll do it.
All right. Sounds good, Dan. Hey, keep in touch, and I look forward to frolicking with you somewhere soon.
You got it. And thanks for being a frequent guest of the show. I'm sure our listeners enjoy hearing of your many travels to far-off places. So thank you very much.
All right. Be good.
All right. You too. Take care. All right. What we're going to do is take one final break, and then I've got a bunch of deals for you. You're not going to want to miss it. So stay tuned for more of the Golf and Travel Show. Are back, and of course that is former member of Fleetwood Mac, Lindsey Buckingham, who got fired this past week. Great guitar player, unusual style, the way he plays without a pick with his fingers. Who knows? That band certainly has had its ups and downs over the years, much more than I can even begin to talk about. But I just thought it would be kind of neat to give you a little ditty by him there for a second. But without further ado, like I say, I've got a bunch of deals for you. As always, I typically try and start out closer and work my way further. There's no exact science to doing that, and my geography can be not always perfect, so bear with me. But first, we have a cruise that starts at least nearby, because it leaves right from here, I believe, in Miami. And this is on the MSC cruise line. And I always like to say this, that my wife actually would possibly join me on this cruise because it's a balcony cabin. She will not stay in an inside cabin. It's too small and claustrophobic for her. And a lot of the deals, of course, that they promote are for those tiny little windowless cabins. But this is not one of those. This, not only is it a balcony cabin, it also includes a package of unlimited drinks. So not only can you see the views, but you can, you could be wasted while you're seeing the views, I guess. But obviously, we know that buying drinks on a cruise line is very expensive. But for a 7-night cruise on the MSC Seaside, you can get all of that, your balcony cabin and your unlimited drink package. You could be visiting ports such as Nassau, San Juan, and St. Martin. And you can even have two kids, 11 and under, for free with two adults. in your room, a reduced deposit of only $99, and it's only $599 per person for all of that. Of course, that includes all your meals, too, and a lot of entertainment. So taxes are a little bit additional. These are for specific sailings, of course. They have September 15th, 29th, and October 13th. Keep in mind that is hurricane season, so there is a little bit of risk. That's why you're getting such a great deal. You got to book this by April 25th. I found this on TravelZoo.com. You can find it there, too. And if you're looking for a great deal, that sure sounds like one to me. If you prefer to keep on dry land, a place that we speak about from time to time because they occasionally have deals, especially in the off season, the PGA Tour just played there. I mean, come on. We are talking about Innisbrook Golf and Spa Resort over in Palm Harbor on the Gulf Coast. Most nights between May 19th and September 22nd, $89 per night. But if that's not good enough, every single day you'll get a $30 credit for meals and drinks. That almost sounds impossible. For a high-quality golf resort. Of course, the golf is not included, but if you do want to play on the Copperhead, which is one of the most difficult golf courses on the PGA Tour, you can do that. They have several other golf courses there, too. They've got the Loch Ness Monster Pool with two watersides and two beach areas for the kids. A 15-foot waterfall is there. I took my kids there many, many years ago. They loved it. Fishing, tennis, nature expeditions, bike rentals, all of that is there. A free shuttle to Honeymoon Island Beach, and it's a short drive to Clearwater Beach, which was just named one of the top beaches in all of America. All of this for $89. Again, I found this on TravelZoo. That's where you need to go to find it. Let's see. I don't have the date that you need to do. Oh, here we go. April 25th. So do not waste time. And deals like that can sell out for particular dates even sooner. It's almost cheaper than staying at home, $89 plus $30 a day in food and beverage. I mean, that's just ridiculous. Here's a place that I've been to many times, including each of these locations, and that would be Costa Rica. Can be a little bit pricey. Here is a great tour that will take you to many parts of the beautiful country, including San Jose, Arenal, which is where the volcano is, Monteverde, which is where the cloud forest is, where you're living in the clouds, basically, and Manuel Antonio, which is one of their largest and best preserves, nature parks. So you get to see all of that over 9 nights. This includes airfare as well, and I believe the airfare is from Miami, so it's convenient. They've got dates from April through December. Although these prices, I believe, are August 30th and September 13th. So other dates might be slightly higher. I don't know. To get all of this, and this includes transportation in a private motor coach, airport transfers, entrance fees. Let me tell you, I've driven on those roads. You don't want to. Let somebody else do it for you. It's much safer. All of this for $1,099. Trust me, that is a great deal. Found on TravelZoo through Gate One, who is the provider for this. You got to book this by April 20th, so you don't have a lot of time to waste. So get on that right away. Earlier in the show, I mentioned the site that I go to get really good airfare. There was those incredible prices to fly to Beijing, China. Well, if you would like to go someplace other than Beijing, also found on Scott's Cheap Flights, which scottscheapflights.com, you can register for free. For free every day, they will email you incredible deals for a small fee. I think it's about $50 a year. They have even better deals that you can get from them, too. So if you truly want to travel quite a bit, for instance, one of the deals that they didn't send me because I didn't pay the $50 was $397 nonstop round trip to Brussels. Come on, you know, is it not worth paying the $50 to get on a deal like that if you're looking to go to Brussels? I think so. But in any event, this deal that they have that I just found yesterday was to Rome. And you can fly there from, they don't have anything listed in Florida, but from New York City, JFK. How about round trip to Rome? Generally between August and February, even including Thanksgiving, not including Christmas and New Year's, normally it would be about $850. This sale right now, $388 round trip from New York JFK to Rome. That's crazy. This is not on a discount carrier, so you're not going to have to pay extra to breathe or get a drink of water. Alitalia, American, Delta, United, or Air Italy. So, but this may go quick, so don't waste time. If you'd rather get a full package to Italy, found on Travelzoo, to Italy's countryside, an area called Umbria, via Great Value Vacations. You'd be staying in four-star hotels for 5 nights at the, I'm not going to say it, it's in Italian, so I won't say it. It includes a complimentary bottle of Italian sparkling wine, wine tasting at a nearby vineyard, breakfast each and every day, a manual shift car for the entire time you're there, and round-trip economy class airfare to and from Rome, starting at as little as $699. So we were talking about airfare for a little bit, you know, around $400, give or take. But for $699, now you're getting hotel, 5 nights, car, and a bunch of other things thrown in. So that's a pretty neat deal. These flights, the least expensive ones are, I'm not quite sure where, but they do have from Los Angeles, Boston, JFK, and from Newark. And you need to book this by April 20th. But again, it may sell out if you don't do it quick. We were talking about Asia with my buddy Scott. China is a great option, but another option that can be very, very expensive is Japan. Have not been there, would love to go. It's always been a little too expensive to me, but this includes actually round trip airfare from either Los Angeles or San Francisco and a cruise. Again, a balcony cabin. So you got your flights, you've got a cruise. I believe it's an 8-night cruise. And we are talking about on Princess, so this is not some rinky-dink cruise line. It starts, let's see, for departure on August 20, let's see, 7th. It's as little as $18.99, airfare and cruise. Remember, 8-night cruise. They have other dates as well that stop in many really cool places throughout Japan and South Korea, or one of them, which costs a little bit higher. It's about $2,100. That leaves on July 19th. That stops in several stops in Japan as well as Taiwan. So one of them actually for $18.99 includes a stop in Russia. So it's pretty cool. They got lots of different options starting at $8.99. It's via Prestige Cruises. You got to hurry up because this opportunity will end by April 18th. So don't waste time. A place that I did go to recently in Asia that I enjoyed thoroughly and I hope to be able to go back again this summer is Thailand. Past times, it was very expensive. These days, not so expensive, okay? Also found on TravelZoo.com. This includes airfare and four-star hotel, $699. You got to book it by April 20th at TravelZoo.com. Go to Thailand. Take my word for it. Thanks again to our guest, Michael O'Brien, General Manager of Fort Lauderdale Country Club, FortLauderdaleCC.com, and Scott Price, Table Tennis Hall of Famer, PingPongMan.com, Facebook.com/The Golf and Travel Show. Like it, and you'll know who our guests are going to be going forward. Talk to you again next week.
You have been listening to The Golf and Travel Show, hosted by Dan Chu. Heard live every Friday, 7 to 8 p.m. on 1470 WWNN, and replayed every Sunday from 6 to 7 p.m. on 740 a.m. WSBR. Visit the show on Facebook and tune in next week. If you are in South Florida or traveling the world, hit them straight. The opinions expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of the station, its staff, management, or sponsors.
Talk 1470 and 95.3 FM, the Health and Wealth Radio Network. Tune in for the Concierge Men's Wellness Show, Fridays at 5:30 p.m. WNN.
It's Thursday night, and you're grabbing drinks with some friends. Started off with a pitcher for the table, which quickly becomes two. There's pool. And there's the photo booth.
All right, everybody squeeze in. Say cheese!
Followed naturally by an order of wings. And another.
Can we get some extra ranch sauce?
Then there's the ceremonial nightcap.
So what are we doing this weekend?
And lastly, it's back to the car, which, if you're buzzed,